Hello friends, a very good day to all of you. Today I am going to discuss about the characteristics of money. In the last session I had discussed about the meaning, definition and a brief description about the motives of money. And today I will discuss in detail the major characteristics or features of money. So let's discuss firstly about the characteristics of money. As the money system is a significant improvement over the barter system, and this system provides a way to quantify the value of goods and communicate it to others. The use of money as a medium of exchange has removed the major difficulties of double coincidence of wants in the barter system, and it separates the act of sale and purchase of goods and services and helps both parties in obtaining maximum satisfaction and profits independently. And it has several defining characteristics. So before discussing the detailed characteristics of money, let me tell you, in the barter system there were some problems that we had discussed, like the double coincidence of want, and it is not possible to measure the money as a medium of exchange because of its perishability. So in order to overcome such problem, the money was defined, and it rectify the maximum problem of medium of exchange as well as the double coincidence of wants. So now I am going to define the major characteristics of money. So these are the major characteristics of money. First is durability. The second characteristic is portability. Third characteristic is divisibility. Next is uniformity. Next is generally acceptable. And the last one is cognizability. So these are the main six characteristics that I am going to discuss in detail one by one. So talking about the first characteristics of money is durability. So durability of money is such that it can be used over and over again. Hence it must survive wear and tear for long period. It should be storable and should not lost its value over a period of time, like gold, silver, alloy, brass, etc. are the best material which can be used as a. So money must have durability, it should be storable and should not lost its value over a period of time. It should sustain over a longer period of a time, and that must be made of best material that can be used over and over again. Another characteristic is portability. Portability is that money which must be able to go wherever, such that it is easy to transport as people travel, and it should be easily carried and transferred from one place to another, and it should contain large value in a small bulk. Means money can be used with a material that should be easily carried and transferred from one place to another. If it should contain large value and with a small quantity, and paper money is considered to be a better money that can easily be portable from one place to another. Now talking about the next characteristics of money is divisibility. So this aspect deals with the fact that money must be easily divided into smaller parts to enable a person to buy different products. Gold, silver, and paper money possess such quality and can be divided into smaller parts with having same value in parts. It means that money should be capable of being divided into smaller part, and the gold, paper money as well as the silver, they have such quality of being divided into a smaller part, and these can easily be used nowadays by a number of people. The next characteristics is uniformity. Uniformity of money calls for a standardization of money so that it looks like the same. Means the material which is used in money should be of same quality. All coins should be of same weight, shape and size. Paper money of different denomination should be of same quality, same design and same size. Now talking about the next characteristics of money is general acceptability. It should be acceptable by everybody. Gold and silver are considered good money material because they have alternative uses and are generally accepted by everyone. Paper money are also accepted, but it must be issued by central bank of a country. So money should be of such type that must be acceptable by everyone within a society, and it should be used with such material which must have been considered by everyone, and that must be generally accepted. So, and in case if it is used paper money, then it must be issued by the central bank of a country like Reserve Bank of India. The another and last characteristics of money is cognizability. So the material which is used in coins should be easily recognized by everyone. It must be of different design and size and should be of good quality. So the material which is used as a money must be recognized by everyone. The material which is not recognized by everyone cannot be termed as money. It should not possess the characteristics to be a money. If it must be of different design and size, but it should be of good quality. So it must be recognizable by everyone within a society. So these are the six characteristics that we had discussed in detail. Thank you everyone. In the next session, I will be dealing with the functions of money. That's all for today. Have a nice day.